Namaste. Today we are going to learn about the Dwadasha Hastaprana Lakshanas, which were explained by Nandikeshwara from Abhinaya Darpana. Okay, the sloka goes like this: Prasaranam kunchitam cha rechitam punkhitam tatha apaveshtitam chapi prerito dveshtite tatha vyavritta parivrittascha sanketa tadanantaram chihnam padarthatiketi prana dvadasha hastaja. So there are 12, dvadasha means 12 hastas Nandikeshwara has explained. Among these 12, the first 9 are only the movements of hands, but the remaining 3 are the ones which convey some action or meaning. So let us see how Nandikeshwara has explained in Abhinaya Darpanam. The first one is Prasarana. Prasarana hasta. The sloka: Prasarana miti gneya mangulinam prasaranat. So prasarana miti gneya, it is known as prasarana. Mangulinam, anguli means fingers, prasarana stretched. So when the fingers are stretched to the front, it is called as prasarana. The second one, kunchita hasta. Kunchana dangulinam cha kunchitam samudiritam. So when the fingers, angulinam, kunchanam, if you fold it, then it is, or bend it, it is called as kunchitam. So kunchanam means bending or folding. Angulinam, the fingers, is known as kunchitam samudiritam. So kunchana, kunchita hasta means, kunchita hasta pranam means fingers are bent. That is called as kunchita. The next one is rechita hasta pranam. Angulinam prachalanat rechitam parikirtitam. So angulinam, fingers, prachalanat, it should move quickly. Then it is called as rechita hasta. Angulinam, fingers, prachalanat, moving fast, is rechitam parikirtitam. The next one is punkhita hasta pranam. Purobhage kunchito va rechito va prasaritaha yo hastastu patakadir namnasau punkhito bhavet. Purobhage means the front part. Kunchito va rechito va prasaritaha, that means it can be bended position or moving position or stretched position. Such hand is called as punkhita. That is, yo hastastu patakadi namnasau punkhito bhavet. So from the pataka hasta, the front part is bent and moved or stretched. It is called as punkhita hasta. Okay, the next one, the fifth one is apaveshtita. Apaveshtita sloka: adhastat gamanam yasya hastasya namna apaveshtitaha. Adhastat, downwards, gamanam, moving towards down, or bringing your palm down, yasya hastasya, that hand, namna apaveshtitaha, it is known as apaveshtita hasta. So the fingers are brought down, hasta is brought down. Adhastat gamanam yasya hastasya namna apaveshtitaha. The next one is prerita hasta. Paschat bhage kunchito va rechito va prasaritaha yo hastah kaditah soyam preritah purva suribhi. So paschat bhage, the back part, is kunchita va rechita va prasaritaha. So this, when it is moving, it is called the back part of the hasta. Paschat bhage, the back part of the hand is paschat bhage kunchito va rechito va prasaritaha yo hasta. That kind of hasta is called as kathito yo hasta kadita soyam prerita purva suribhi. The next one is udveshtita hasta. Hastana murdhvabhage yad gamanam chasti nartane udveshtita mityahu bharatagama vedibhi. So hastana murdhvabhage yad gamanam. Gamanam means movement. Where? To the upper part. Murdhvabhage, to the up. Hastanam, hand. Hastana murdhvabhage yad gamanam chapi nartane. While dancing, if the hands are going from the front up, it is called as udveshtita hasta. Tad udveshtita mityahu bharatagama vedibhi. Hastana murdhvabhage means up. Yad gamanam, move. Chasti nartane, while dancing. Tad udveshtita mityahu bharatagama vedibhi. So, moving your hand while dancing, if you are bringing the hand up, then it is called as udveshtita. Then, vyavritta. Udagrata parshvabhage hasto vyavrittako bhaved. So, udagrata mean agrabhagam, again up. Parshvabhage, from the side. Hasto vyavrittako bhaved. If you are moving your hand from the side, then it is called as vyavritta. The next one is parivritta hasta. Parshvabhyam cha purobhage yo hasto natane krita. Parivritta samakhyata namna hasta visharadai. So parshvabhyam, from the side, purobhage, to the front, yo hasta, which hand you are bringing, natane krita while dancing, parivritta samakhyata namna hasta visharadai. The scholars who are explaining the hand movements, it is considered, if you are bringing the hand from the side, from the parshvabhaga to the front, then it is called as parivritta hasta. As I said, these 9 are the movements of the hands. Now the remaining 3 will be conveying some meaning. Let us see what it is. Sanketa prana hasta. Uha vidhana rachana vina sthulokti purvakam yo hasto niyamam prapta sah sanketa udahrita. So uha vidhana rachana vina sulokti purvakam, just with the signs, if you are conveying without words, if you are with the help of the signs, if you are conveying, then it is called a sanketa. Come here. Go there. Go away. Or go there. See. Don't talk. I'm getting angry. I'll beat you. Okay. I don't want to hear. All these signs will convey the meaning or your intention, what you want to convey, without using the word. They are called as Sanketa Hasta Prana. The next one is Chihna. Pratyakshanam Parokshanam Vastunam Natyakarmini Sthavaratvam Jangamatva Miyushamapi Tadrisham Tadakara Prakatanam Tan Mukhasya Nirikshanam Tat Sthana Darshanam Chapi Tadvajanam Cha Darshanam Tadhayudha Prakatanam Tat Gatardha Nivedanam Tadvyapta Darshanam Chapi Tat Cheshta Darshanam Tadha Ashta Lakshana Mityeta Chihna Mityabhidhiyate. So, Ashta Lakshana means 8 Lakshanas. it is explained that about the chihna. So what all it indicates? Okay, it will be indicating their forms, their faces, their dwelling places, their banners, their weapons, their virtues, their ranges, and their actions. If these are conveyed through again gestures, they are called as chihna prana lakshana. Now suppose you have to show a cow, you show like this, isn't it? And if you want to show fish, or you want to say where it lives, okay, so birds, it will be on the tree. Okay, and if you are holding some villain characters, especially anti-hero character, we have to show. We just show the mace holding gada and walking. Isn't it? So these are the chihnas which are used to convey some meaning or intention or whatever it is. Okay, the next one, the last one is padarthatika. Padanam kathitanam syadartha nirvahata yadi iyam padarthatiketi kathita bharatadibe. So it is, you know, while with the, we can understand this padarthatika, which we use the asamvita samvita hastas to convey the meaning, you know, this is three for woman, this is for man, okay, but this is for only Krishna. It is chihna, okay, because it is chihna. Rama we will do like this, it is chihna for Rama, okay, and Ravanasura we will do like this, this is the chihnam for Ravanasura. So the difference between the chihna, Sanketa and Padarthitika we have to understand. Now let us just see how according to the sloka we have to do. Okay, because all these things while explaining the sloka or rendering the sloka, we will not be able to do the three one, but the nine movements we can do, like prasaranam, kunchitam, rechitam, punkhitam tadha, apaveshtitakam chapi, prerito, udveshtite tadha, vyavritta, it should be, the palm should be up, you know, vyavritta, okay. Parivrittascha sanketa tadanantaram chihnam padardhati keti pranadvadasha hastajah.